Brad, thanks, and welcome back to you, too. And just because the Islanders haven't played in a couple of weeks doesn't mean that they haven't made some news. Rick DiPietro has been placed on injured reserve, so he'll be out for at least a week. They say it's indefinite. But the bigger news today was the trade, which sent Andy Sutton, the soon-to-be free agent defenseman who is having perhaps his best year in the National Hockey League, to the Ottawa Senators for a second-round draft pick.
Not perhaps. It's definitely Andy Sutton's best year, the 11th-year professional. Works his way to the Ottawa Senators, a team that's going to the playoffs. Sutton has played in just 4 playoff games, all in the same year with the Atlanta Thrashers, the year they got swept by the Rangers. So he'll get a chance to go into the postseason as he finds a new place. This is a good fit, I think, for Andy Sutton, but also a good trade for Gar Snow and the New York Islanders. They get a second-round pick. That is what it's all about right now. Guys, are defensemen are being traded. Nick Vallin got sent for a second-round pick to San Jose. A fair trade for Andy Sutton. He has ferocious body checks. He's been good in front of his own net. He's been solid with the puck offensively as well. Again, a good deal for both sides.
And so general manager Garth Snow explains his reasons for the deal.
I think a move of this nature, there's a few different variables. One, it's good for us for the future. We get a second-round pick. When you have players like Andrew McDonald and Jack Hillen's coming back tonight healthy, Dustin Cohn have played really well for us. So for us, you know, we feel that we can win on any given night. Just because we're young doesn't mean we can't win hockey games.
Well, I think the important point here, Billy, is that was the market for Andy Sutton, a second-round pick. And so when people say, hey, he could have gotten more, well, he knows what the market was. Mm-hmm. And he's been loading up on draft picks the last couple of years. That's something that is a movable commodity.
He had to make the deal as well, Howie. There was no guarantee. As much as Andy Sutton enjoyed being a New York Islander, that he was going to re-sign with the New York Islanders. This team, the Islanders, cannot afford to take that chance. In a few years, maybe, if there's a guy that they really like an awful lot that can help propel them into a higher playoff position. Not this year, though. They're not ready yet. Gar Snow had to make the move, the right move, and got the best return.
Pretty impressive team here at the Coliseum tonight, the Chicago Black.
He is our Emblem Health injury report. Emblem Health, the plan that works. The Islanders announced tonight that he's been placed on injured reserve with knee swelling, retroactive to February 28th, but Rick worked out yesterday, didn't like how his knee swelled, went to the doctor. If we hear any more, we'll pass it along. The Islanders get some healthy bodies back. Josh Bailey, Tim Jackman, and Jack Hillen are all back. Bailey will play on the left with Tavares and Oposo. And Dustin Cohn got the call this morning in Bridgeport, got here in plenty of time to replace Andy Sutton in the lineup tonight. Dwayne Rolison, the object of affection of a few teams out there, will be in goal tonight. Again, the Islanders for the moment back to 2 goaltenders. And Antti Niemi has been the Blackhawks' go-to guy lately. He'll be in there tonight. Howie?
All right, thanks very much, Deb. And so, Jack Hillen back in business. You see the protective shield after the broken jaw. And what about his weight? You know, that's got to be a bit of a concern.
He's just starting to be able to eat milder, soft foods, very, very soft foods. Guys were giving it to him in the locker room yesterday, saying SpaghettiOs. That's his culinary qualifications, I guess, right there. I said, a lot of pasta. He said, yes, and I overcook it as much as you can. He's lost about 10 pounds, though. He isn't that big to begin with, but he feels strong. He's listed at 5'11", 200, so that means he's pushing 190 or so right now. Speaking of other guys that aren't that big right there, Patrick Kane, but both those players, Kane and Hillen, fearless. They will use their bodies in high traffic areas.
And so the Islanders begin with Franz Nielsen between Matt Molson and Trent Hunter. Mark Streit paired with Andrew McDonald on defense as it's brought in by Taves. And that first drive is a stick save by Rolison. And then McDonald, with that long stick of his, made a good play to prevent the rebound from getting through. And of course, since we saw you last, Andrew McDonald got himself a 4-year contract extension.
Long stick, better wallet.
Matt Molson sends it in. I asked him before if somebody would have told him during training camp that 5 months later he'd have a 4-year contract in his pocket, what would he have thought? And basically, you could fill in the blank. He said, I think he was crazy.
4 years, $2.2 million. Well earned by a great young guy.
Brent Seabrook on defense number 7, one of those 6 Blackhawk Olympians, got it to center. And an almost Olympian, Kyle Oposo, throws it back in. I wonder about the Hawks with all those players coming back just 2 days. At least those 4 of those participated in the gold medal game on Sunday. You know, are they going to have their legs or their minds going to be into this? I think that's as much an issue as anything from a physical standpoint. Not a great segue. Campbell's drive is kicked out by Rolison. For those players who have been around, though, it's a much different situation. They're sick of the practices over the last week. They want a game, and they've got one. Carlmosson, number four, throws it around the board. That's Niklas Hjalmarsson out of Sweden. And Hossa, who missed the first 22 games this year after shoulder surgery, turns it to Hjalmarsson for the dump-in. Dustin Cone back up, and I would think a good chance he'll be back here the rest of the way now with Andy Sutton having been traded.
Well, he's seen his ice time increase since he came up originally with the Islanders. He was playing 6-7 minutes then, recently 11 to 13 minutes a game, as he's earned the trust of the coaching staff.
And Tim Jackman goes right to work on the forecheck, his first shift since New Year's Eve, December the 31st, when he suffered an injury to the orbital bone in his eye. Rolison wheels the puck around the board. And of course, Rolly is right in the midst of all kinds of speculation with a trade deadline tomorrow at 3 p.m. And the team he's facing tonight, the Chicago Blackhawks, are one of those rumored to be interested. And that's all we can tell you. It's all rumor at this point. Rolison left the rebound out in front, made two saves, including the second on Madden. And it's John Madden, number 11, the former New Jersey Devil. He's got it again here. Out now to Campbell. That drive tip slithers in front and is grabbed by Rolison.
And a real good play by John Sim in front of the net. He boxes out with Big Ben Eager in front of Dwayne Rolison as well. And so Sim on the ice helps his goaltender keep it a scoreless game. Shot is low. Not the hardest shot right there, but right there you see how Sim backs into Ben Eager, puts his backside into the hip of Eager. And before that, it was a rebound left out for John Matt. And there comes Dwayne Rolison. Good positional play, making the save.
Sign not only refers to, but is signed by Mark Strider, delivers tonight's Geico quote.
Well, a lot of great reaction, you know, from Switzerland and even from here, you know, a lot of people texted me and congratulated me on the way we played. You know, I thought we did a really good job representing Switzerland, put them on the hockey map a little bit. So that was great. The feedback was really positive.
And it rolls all the way down, icing waved off. Kane gets the only assist. For what it's worth, Kane has a five-game point streak, but really, his Cone shot is slapped away in front. It's been a couple of weeks. Meyer a shot, and that's tipped wide. So really, little point streaks are hardly relevant when the guys haven't played for a couple of weeks, at least not in the NHL. But it'll look good at contract time if somebody's got one going and has the opportunity to negotiate a deal. Como with steal, he scores! And Como ties it 1-1.
Let's talk streaks.
Three for him.
Three in a row for Blake Como. This is all about stick positioning. Niemi moves it up. And here's Seabrook with his feet flat. It's intercepted or deflected off the stick of Robbie Shrimp. Shrimp is going to come right up into here, and he's going to watch the stick. He's going to come right in there. Como in the right spot. Second forward sizzles it just above the pad of Antti Niemi with a quick release. 1-1 to score.
10 goals now for Blake Como, and he's come a long way. You know, he talks so often about the young Islander nucleus, and you know, guys like Blake Como have been looked at more as the supporting players rather than the headliners, Tavares or Raposo or Bailey, the high draft picks. And a penalty coming up here. A stick was slashed in half.
Going to be on Richard Park. All right, let's break down this goal by Blake Como. First of all, Robbie Shrimp is number one. Blake Como's number two. The puck is back here. Seabrook's, go ahead and roll it, guys. Now we're going to stop right there because Seabrook's looking to go all the way up here with this long cross-ice pass. But look what Robbie Shrimp does with his stick. Puts it into the lane. In comes Blake Como after the deflection. And even though he's got Jackman coming on the right side, he can ill afford to take the time, get rid of the puck quickly. And that's what Como did there. A little element of surprise beating Niemi.
Carrying the puck, getting in on the forecheck.
About shooting it quicker.
Yeah.
To me, that's a real confidence, sign of confidence when you get rid of the puck quickly.
Now Campbell with some space. Draws Como down. Wrist shot stopped by Rolison. And he got the rebound as well. And then maybe the Islanders got away with one there as knocked down was Versteeg. Now to Bufflin. 20 shots in the period for the Hawks. They've got 5 minutes left. Their lead is just 2-1. Campbell out to the line. Covered now by Brouwer. Roy Brouwer, number 22. Work the other way. Versteeg waits along the boards. And now Campbell. Two Islanders to him. So he circles away. Nobody in front. Campbell waiting. In fact, he was waiting for Ladd, who would come off the bench and was charged.
A lot worse.
Let's take a look at Dwayne Rolison in net. Is there any thought in his mind, Butch, with the trading deadline looming?
I don't think so. He's just such a competitor and such an intense guy. And you can see that, you know, it wouldn't matter whether they're playing the last place club, Toronto Maple Leafs, for example. He'd still be trying to make saves. And you know, he had a terrific first period. The one goal got by him. He didn't.
Osa puts it down the boards for Kopetsky. And then Hossa grabs it back. Three Islanders went to him. So Bolin looks to make a play. Sends it all the way to Campbell at the line for a drive that's tipped wide.
Very similar type of shot play that led to the goal by Patrick Kane from Duncan Keith. Remember from that area how he head up looking for his forwards at all time. Allows the forwards to get in position without giving away. If you put your head down as a defender, as a shot blocker, you know that that guy's committed to taking the shot. You keep the head up, it's more of a challenge.
High stick knocks down Law of the puck, and that's why play is stopped. With 2:07 gone in the second period. Two good young hockey players, one for the Islanders, Kyle Oposo.
And the other one, Jonathan Toews for the Chicago Blackhawks. Great friends out. They developed their friendship back in the 03, 04, and 04, 05 years when they were both teammates at Shattuck St. Mary's, where they were ultra, ultra competitive. They would compete on the ice in practice. They would compete playing flag football. They would compete in math class, albeit Jonathan Toews said Kyle Oposo did much better than I could in that class ever. But in the 04-05 season, Toews had 110 points, Oposo 92 for Shattuck St. Mary's.
Here's Strike lining one up. Shrimp to Como. He shoots. He scores. Blake Como again.
West over to Como. Quick shot as the Hawks do not rotate to get him quickly. And for the second time in this game, a snapshot by Blake Como leads Antti Niemi. Niemi got beat over the pad on the first one in the first period. This one beats him over the glove with a high shot, a rocket of a shot. Great pass by Robbie Schrempf to make that play happen.
And also the presence and size of Tim Jackman in front of the net, helping tie up Kim Janssen and make it a little difficult, and more so for Niemi. So two for Como, two for the Blackhawks. 2:27, the time of Como's goal, and the Islanders take the lead. Sim was right out in front and poked it past Niemi, and the Islanders are on top 3-2, two goals in 25 seconds.
Body positioning, owning the real estate in front of Antti Niemi. And I think we're going to have a goaltender change. We are. Cristobal Ua comes in for Antti Niemi. Joe Quenneville not happy with what he's seen as his team had a dominant first period, but are down by a goal now. After two goals in 25 seconds from the Islanders, neither Madden nor Campbell end up getting Sim. Even if he doesn't touch this puck, Howie, it ends up being great net presence for John Sim. And if he gets it, great. If not, it's Richard Park. This overhead will perhaps show better. No, it goes off the backside of Brian Campbell and in the net. But Campbell is brought to that area of the ice because Sim is there as well. This surprises me that Antti Niemi gets pulled despite being down by just the goal. I think Quenneville must not have liked the two goals that he got beat by Blake Como on. One over that right pad.
High,
no,
yeah.
No, one was over the right pad. Second one was up high.
And now Nielsen for the Islanders throws it in, but again it just, you know, outlines what's been one of the storylines or underlying stories of this game, the last one before the deadline for the Blackhawks, and the uncertainty about their goaltending situation.
Absolutely. So Quenneville will mix things up just like just about every coach in the NHL. Now very rare the lines stay together.
Here's Bufflin. Nice move, but he missed wide on the glove side. Campbell Now for John Madden. That hopped over Bufflin's stick. And Sharmelson for Madden, but he couldn't hold on. Maybe the Islanders just getting their legs a little bit now,
yeah,
too.
That's what I think. I think they needed that break at the end of the first, and it did them a whole lot of good. And it doesn't seem to have helped the Blackhawks out.
Those 2 minutes, the Blackhawks pretty much owned the puck again, and it looked so much like the first period. Since then, though, the Islanders have found their equilibrium and taken the lead. And Molson for Park, he scores! Richard Park makes it 4-2. And all the questions about the Blackhawks goaltending get deeper and deeper and deeper.
Last time that UA played was February 1st, the shootout loss to the Phoenix Coyotes. This is one that he's got to have. That's just not a goal that can be, it's not a permissible goal. And if people continue to wonder how long will Dwayne Roloson be in an Islander uniform,
at this rate,
Stan Bowman, the general manager, I wonder if he's getting an itchy dialing finger right now. That is not a happy man in Joel Quenneville right now with his goaltender, or his team for that matter.
At this rate, Snowy might get 2 number ones for him. Remember, this is a Chicago team that comes in second in the Western Conference with all the talent in the world, apart from the goaltender. So the Islanders with a 4-2 lead. Richard Park coming up with his 7th goal of the year. Centering feed, but Taves was well covered by McDonald.
I mean, it gives you kind of that comfort zone that, you know, obviously you can't slack off and be like, all right, I'm here now, but you got to, you know, you got to work at it and keep getting better, and you're always working towards the future.
What'd you go buy, the first thing you bought?
I didn't really buy anything yet. I'm probably going to go get a new car, though, soon.
Deb just had to ask about the shopping aspect, didn't she?
I'm sure she could figure out a few things he could spend it on.
Good one, Mayor. 9:26 to go in the second period.
A very fair deal for both the player and for the team. Very cap friendly. It's like 4 years, about $2.2 million total. Gives the player that sense of security and belonging, but also gives the team a lot of flexibility and, you know, a lot of maneuverability because it's a very fair number.
Well, Andrew's parents are coming to New York early next month for the first time as a tandem. His dad's been here, but his mom has not been to New York, Andrew is saying, and so there may be a few of those dollars spent in Manhattan once the McDonald's get in, and that'll be just fine with Andrew.
Well, boy, and is he a great example of what taking just a little bit of time with a young defenseman and what you hope translate into that being success. And hopefully Dustin Cohn will have that similar type of experience. And in the next few years, guys like Calvin DeHaan and Travis Hamonic, you know, those type of players, if they can continue to develop young defensemen like they have with McDonald, the Islanders could find themselves in nice shape in a few years.
And each of those
here, the 4th pick overall in the 09 draft. Thrashers are up 4-2 in the second period over the Florida Panthers, a team that might have a bit of their own fire sale before the trade deadline passes at 3 p.m. East tomorrow.
McDonald with an outlet. Wasn't handled cleanly by Tavares, but the Islanders get it deep anyway. Not deep enough, though, as UA was able to cut it off. Islanders get it back. Bailey turned around by Versteeg. Now Tavares, double teamed. Oposo back to the line. McDonald, the strike, the drive, and that knuckled up high. As we reached the final minute of the period, as it came up high, it deflected over the glass and out of play.
Yeah, but again,
even though the puck came back down onto the ice.
Sorry, again, you have guys in front of the net. You've got two guys. In this instance, it was Bailey. Tavares was to the side as well. They find the puck. They find the play, and they get the bodies to the front of the net. And by doing that, they create all kinds of traffic. They create a screen on Cristobal Ue, and they get that net presence.
Here comes Sharp with Kane. And Kane sends it down the board. 48 seconds to go in the period. Sharp with two Islanders on him. Taves put it through the slot. Backed up at the line. Carmelson a drive. And a save by Roloson. And there'll be a faceoff in the Islanders' zone.
And nice save by Roloson. In front of the net, Strite is also moving out his fellow Olympian, Jonathan Taves, with good body positioning. I've talked about that a few times in this game. But watch, you'll see the puck coming back, and in front you're going to see Marchand. Look, he looks over his right shoulder for Tate, and then right there he's going to turn the body in just a little right there, keep the stick up, but by just having his body next to Jonathan Toews, that allows the lane to be open for Roleson to see the puck.
Shots are 30-19 Chicago, but they had 22 of the first 38. Since then, the Islanders have outshot the Hawks 13-8 as the Islanders found their legs just a couple of minutes into the second period. And now strike for Como. He shoots, he scores! Hat trick, Blake Como! 5-2 Islanders!
Six goals now in his last three games as the hats and other items come cascading. Oh, it's the giveaway. It's the giveaway today here at the Coliseum.
You know what?
Come cascading onto the ice.
Well, they keep cascading. They might as well send the teams to their room now and tack on the 17.3 seconds to the third.
Howie, there's two great plays by Islander defensemen. The first one is going to be Andrew McDonald, the fake shot pass. Then Mark Streit, the fake shot as well. What happens is they get the Hawks defenders to commit to different areas, and it leaves Blake Como available for the pass. This is the second one right there. You see how Kopetsky went? He went to block the shot. He brought the legs together. It leads to that high slot area. The recognition for Como, and the puck goes in. And I beg your pardon, it was Kane, not Kopetsky, that went into that shot blocking mode. But Blake Como, who's going to move right to the middle, calls for it right there. Quick shot. This is the second time in this game, third time, that he has gotten rid of the puck ultra quick, Howie. And again, to me, that is a huge sign of confidence. What a shot beating the blocker side of Cristobal Oue. What a fun second period.
Yeah, and the fans still having fun throwing things on the ice. Now, there is precedent. Often when situations like this have arisen, the officials will send the teams to the room and they'll tack the 17 seconds in this case and change onto the third. But looks like they're going to keep the players around until they finish cleaning
up. Yeah, let's watch this. Now, let's hold it right here for 1 second. Blake Coble's up there. Go ahead and roll it and watch how he follows the play over to here. Now, the puck's going to come back to Andrew McDonald. Watch right here. One fake. Mark Streit's going to be the second fake right there. And then to the middle of the ice comes Blake Como. You have three Islanders lined up. Net presence by Nielsen. Low mid slot by Oposo. High slot, Blake Como. The quick release. A thing of beauty. And the cleanup seems to be just about done. What are those giveaways tonight, by the way?
I don't know. We didn't get them. I don't know.
We did not.
What a night for Blake Como. We talked about him after the first period being the best Islander in that period, and he's just continued right on. This is a tremendous game for him. And he's the guy we talked about, the Islanders having to get better, their young guys having to get better. Well, certainly Como was taking the right steps.
And it has not always been easy for Blake Como. He has not always been able, even this year, to achieve that level of consistency, Butch, that the coaching staff and the player himself knew and wanted that he needed to be at. But it's a message that has got to be continued to be given, imparted on the player, and also you have to got to continue showing confidence in him. Scott Gordon has shown him video, and again, it hasn't always been easy for Blake Como. There have been times where he's been scratched. I know there's been times the question is confidence, but right now his confidence is sky high. Now the key for a young player like this, Howie, is you don't rest on the laurels. You say, what did I do to get to that level? Now let me take it to the next level. This is the type of play, hopefully, that Blake Como can build off of.
Back at the intermission, the Islanders have chased a goaltender. If Joel Quenneville had a third, he might consider it, but it's 5-2 Islanders after 40 minutes, and Blake Como already has a hat trick. You had your legs in the first period, but it seems like your teammates have caught up with you.
Yeah, you know, I thought the guys did a good job that second period. We knew it was big to get that next goal, and you know, that's the thing about our team. I feel like we have four lines that all can contribute, and we proved that the second period.
All right, let's go through your goals. How long has it been since you've had a hat trick?
Scott asked me that question on the bench. I told him maybe Pee-wee, but no, it's been a while, so it's a nice feeling.
All right, let's take a look at them. One in the first and then two in this period. The first one, I think, off a turnover.
Yeah, it was. Shrempf did a good job on the forecheck. You know, I got the puck and tried to get it off quick, and it went in. Second one, Rob, another great pass. I think he heard me back door, and I tried to put it upstairs and found its way in. And then the last one here, I called Mark off. I thought he was going to shoot it. You know, I just got in the slot, tried to put it in, so it's nice.
It's not been an overnight success for you getting to the National Hockey League and scoring at this rate. How do you feel about where you are right now at 20 games to go?
Well, I mean, obviously it's a confidence booster. You know, I haven't scored like this in a while, and you know, I think talking with Scott, there's some other aspects of my game that I thought I could do better. Playing physical, playing good in the defensive zone, and bring that stuff like that if I'm not scoring. So it's a nice cherry on the cake to be able to score.
Well, congratulations on the three so far.
Thanks a lot.
Okay, Blake Como reached double figures tonight with his 10th. He's also now got his 11th and his 12th, and the Islanders have a three-goal lead on the talented Blackhawks. We'll take a break and continue here at the intermission right after.
So Park has two, and Como has three, and the Islanders up 5-2. Billy, you pretty much called that after we showed the replay back in the first period. It was the Islanders' second goal, actually early in the second. Down low, Madden and across. Rollison got a piece of it as they had two forwards loose down low. And Madden made a pass that was just begging to be finished to Rollison's right by Versteeg. And Rollison got a stick on it, and the crowd, you might hear, is saluting him. Versteeg in again. Chris Versteeg tried to play it across. A lot of traffic to get it through, and Jackman checked by Hunter. Hossa steps up and shoots one that's gobbled up by Rollison.
Holding on to the puck is Marian Hossa, one and done, and we're seeing more of that right now. Here's earlier. Stick is just inside the net. This is the Versteeg opportunity. Tight play, but Versteeg had actually his skates, what you couldn't tell from that angle, how his skates are already behind the goal line right there. It's a nice backhand pass. Like I said, the Kane was in deep.
12:42 to go in the third. Mark Streit reverses towards McDonald. He failed to get it up the boards. Eager loose in front, in deep, put it along the goal line before it rolled behind the net. Rollison without his goal stick here, and he's got traffic in front of him. Keith's drive missed. Kopetsky gets the rebound to Hossa. He had a shot blocked by McDonald. Rebound came up high on Rollison. Now the puck back to the blue line for Keith. Seabrook lines it up. The shot blocked. McDonald slid out, and Rollison reaches to grab his stick. So Rollison has his stick back now. And the Islanders, with John Sim doing a lot of the dirty work, push it up. Now Bolin gets it back, moves it into the zone for Ladd to the other side, centering feed. Hossa and Rollison stop that.
Hossa can't believe it. Can't believe it, how the puck went off the side into his skates, off his stick. Wayne Rollison able to make the save, though. Isle still up by three.
For another faceoff man. Even though he's a righty, he didn't turn his hand back here. He will be happy to go back to McDonald in front of Rollison there. Streit ends up helping out with a nice play on Hossa, Howie. And McDonald flutters it all the way down. With a minute 20 left. Hossa watching Kim Jansen. And now Kane plays it deep. Keeps going against McDonald and gets some help from John Madden. Well, we come down to the final minute. Kane to Bolin. Loose puck in front. They jam away at it. Rollison makes a save with his left hand to keep it out. Jansen with Rollison down. Couldn't lift the puck. Rollison slow to get up. Now he's up, but he doesn't have his goal stick. Now he picks that up. And Bailey takes down Jansen. Nothing called there. And the puck sent deep into the Chicago zone. 38 seconds remaining. And a high stick called as the reason for play stopping. High stick knocking the puck down.
Dwayne Rollison's going to find the puck down low on the stick of Marian Hossa. He's going to battle it out right there, and he flops down. Thinks he has it, but he doesn't. Hossa's able to fish it out. Scramble ensues. Islanders will eventually get it out. Rollison again with a real solid game, huh? I mean, you got to look at Dwayne Rollison after that first period. It's a huge, huge difference.
Myers shouldered Patrick Sharp. And once again, Dean Morton finds himself in the path of the puck. And then Seabrook got a piece of it. So Dean Morton can't wait for these next 17 seconds to wind down. Remember, he took a puck off the face earlier in this game. Down to 10, and the Islanders have a win against one of the NHL's best, the Chicago Blackhawks. Offside the call with 3.8 remaining. The crowd saluting the Islanders. And silver medal winning assistant coach of Team USA, Scott Gordon, was able to focus on his team in the short amount of time between the end of the gold medal game. Joel Quenneville had to have been concerned about how his six Olympians would respond so soon after. And the Islanders got what they wanted.
I'd love to hear if Scott Gordon said anything to his team after the first period, because they came out a much different team in the second.
Well, he's still coaching and the game's over.
Nice talking to Richard Park about situations. But Dwayne Rollison, first Islander, other than Rick DiPietro, with 20 wins since Osgood. Chris Osgood did it in the 01-02 season. And we'll see how long Dwayne Rollison, who knows, could be here a long time. Might make a move by tomorrow.
The Islanders with a 5-3 win over the Blackhawks congratulate each other, in particular Dwayne Rollison, as you saw, a 20-game winner. And their dominance over the Blackhawks continues, going back a long, long time, December of 2002. Now, keep in mind, these teams sometimes play once a year. And in that stretch there, I think was a year or two where they didn't play at all, at least one year. Remember the way the schedule used to be worked out.
Peter Menino with a great effort, remember, in Chicago last year. A rookie goaltender. Now you get a veteran goaltender with a great performance here in Dwayne Rollison in the first period that helps keep his team in the game. And then something clicked, something changed. Energy for one squad, less energy for the other in the Hawks. And the Islanders come out and they took advantage of some shaky goaltending. But man, oh man, did they play hard in the second period. And that was the real difference. They played hard. They got the saves they needed in the first as well.
Now the three stars of the game will be announced soon enough. And we can pretty much guess them all, considering the way things went. No question about Richard Park.
Not just his goals either. I thought he had some important faceoffs. And yes, the Hawks were, they won the faceoff battle, but how about that last one at the end of the game by Park out there in his own zone? Subtle things. Veteran player Richard Park.
New York Islanders, number 30, Dwayne Rollison.
Enough said right there. Extremely well deserved.
Had there not been a hat trick, he might have been the first star of the game. However, you know who is star number one. Three goals for the first time in one game in his NHL career. Blake Como, who has been one of the real nice stories for this Islander team over the second half of this season. And as a reward, he gets to chat with Deb.
So it's the Hawks with Niemi in goal up against the Islanders and Rollison on Comcast Sportsnet Chicago.
Rafalski finding Kane in the Olympics.
Kane has it now, shooting, far off, rebound, they score! Tapped home by Brian Campbell up on the rush. He found the rebound, scored his first goal in 15 games, and the Blackhawks have the lead.
What pace are the Hawks on?
Here's Como, shooting, he scores! Blake Como! Taves takes a look back to Duncan Keith. He's open. He'll bring it. Oh, he's open for a tip. And Kane tipped away the wraparound. And he scored! Patrick Kane able to complete a wraparound. Rollison got a piece, but not enough. Here's Streit looking. Goes down low, Schremp centered. Here's Como. He scored! Blake Como gets his second goal. His speed's going wide on Campbell. Gonna get the puck to the net. Not that time. Park still with it. Shoots one. Niemi. Oh, they score! Battling hard in front of the net. The Islanders' John Sim.
Out goes Niemi. In goes Fue.
Matt Molson put it ahead for Richard Park. Teeing it up. He scored! Well, that's three goals over the glove hand of the Blackhawk netminders, and it's 4-2. Held in McDonald. He goes to Strike. Takes a look in front. Como, hat trick for Blake Como. That one by the stick side of UA, and it's 5-2. He whiffed on a clear, taken by Keith. Looks in front, eager. A shot, it got to the goal line, not over. Now he gets it back for Stieg with a drive. They score! Ben, no goal. Ben Eager battling hard out in front of the net. It deflected in. The call is no goal due to incidental contact with a goaltender. Centered, but Kane checked. It goes to Taves with a wraparound. Here's Bufflin. He scored! Dustin Bufflin is the wraparound attempt. a good start to the stretch run for the Islanders and Dwayne Roloson.
You know, they beat him last year right at the United Center with Peter Menino making 40 saves. On this night, it's Dwayne Roloson with a terrific performance. 41 saves, as a matter of fact, as the Islanders beat the Blackhawks by a count of 5-3 for just their third win in the last 12. And how do they do it? Not only goaltending, but this man. Blake Como is red hot. He's got 6 goals and 7 points in the last 3 games, including his first career hat trick on this night. So, nice work for the Islanders as they try to stay in the race in the Eastern Conference. From a Hawks side, you're going, okay, first loss in 5, no big deal. Duncan Keith -3, probably just a blip. But in the last 4 games, they've given up 16 goals, and the trade deadline is approaching, and people are still worried about their goaltending.